replacing and cleaning out my vape. Because a vape is something that essentially is inserted into your mouth and into your lungs in a way. We want to make sure that it is clean and hygienic. So, I'll quickly show you what I have here. Here is the liquid that will be going back inside of the vape once the coil is replaced and cleaned out. The vape cleaned out, rather. It is fruity CBD. Amazing grape. It's a 120ml bottle with added nic shots to add the nicotine. So this is what is going back into the vape. It's not my favourite liquid. It's just the liquid I'm using at the moment. I don't often buy multiple bottles of different flavours. I normally pick a flavour, stick with it, unless I want to experiment a little with the flavours. But that involves even more work in terms of cleaning it out, because you don't want residual flavours for when you want just a clean, fresh taste. So that will be going back into the vape. We have some kitchen roll here. This will be used to help drain the tank and to help tidy anything else up that doesn't need any sort of precision, because these sticks, or Q-tips as they are also called. These will be handy for cleaning inside the mouthpiece and any smaller areas. We have a spare glass. I don't think I'm going to need this today. This one that I have on is just fine, no damages, no cracks. But you never know, so I always have a spare. Here are some extra little bits and pieces. These are the seals to help keep the vape liquid in. This particular vape is also waterproof and dustproof, so some of these parts help with just the coil. Now the one that is currently in my vape is a super mesh coil. This one is not a mesh coil. although it is still a very nice, very high quality coil. And then here is just the box for anybody interested in that. IP67 water and dust resistance, high shock resistance, upgraded AS chip, fast and accurate, coloured display screen, powered with dual 18650 batteries. You can put bigger batteries in it, but I tend to stick with 18650s. So, once again, here is the vape itself. The screen. I think it will be a bit hard to see. It's got a mixture of rubber, an alloy, and leather for the body. It has an adjustable vent. Hard to see, but it is there. And your typical button to kind of hold the vape. Your plus and minus keys to up the wattage, and pressing and holding both together locks the wattage on this particular device. On some devices, it also locks the trigger button. So let's get started. First of all, we want to drain. Do this, we simply dismantle the tank. So we remove the tank from the body. First of all, I'm going to do, just in case of accidental shocks, you shouldn't really get a shock, but I am going to remove. I said it's powered by two 18650s, one of which gets stuck. There we go. So these are the batteries. I do have spare batteries in case these ever decide to just not work. We will put these to one side as they're not. So now that the vape is a little safe to use, no accidental triggering, we can remove the tank from the body. So we want to remove the liquid. To do that, you just twist essentially the tank, the coil, off. It's double-ended screws. So one side comes off, and then the other side comes off. This is where it can get a little bit sticky. So you can leave one side on the cloth or the kitchen roll, kitchen towel. And here we have the coil. As you can see, it's an unhealthy shade of brown. This is not dirt. This is simply the coil burning the cotton on the inside. This is what gives the vape an unpleasant flavor. Also, sometimes I'll have to grip with wet hands. Everywhere. So here is the housing. You want to remember which way the coil goes inside. There is only one way. So just kind of remember that. Since this is no longer needed, we can put it to one side. I'm not going to worry too much about any sticky residue from the coil. What I do want to do now is quickly clean off the tank sections. I'll just quickly use this to dry off my fingers to get a better grip. Easy to remove. Just don't sit there and think, oh no, there's little bits of fluff, whatever will I do? Because they come out really easy with just a little bit of cloth. Section of the tank. With it being smaller, we can give it a quick once over. And as you may be able to see, there is a lot of grime. This is only about a week old. So just think about what you're vaping. What could essentially be going through your vape if you don't clean it regularly? And if you just empty the tank, change a new coil and leave it as it is. Remember, these are not things to be taken lightly in terms of hygiene. You should look after them. It preserves the flavor a little more. You get a better experience. You're not vaping up any nasty bits. So remember to always clean out your vape, especially when changing the coil. lots of residue. This shouldn't normally get mucky, but for the sake of cleanliness and habit, we will clean it. So I realize that these microphones aren't being used too much. They are mainly here to just pick up any small sounds in a little more fidelity. Here is the important part. This is your first point of contact. The vape. Always make sure your mouthpiece is clean. As you will see now, just the dirt and the grime that can be picked up simply from vaping. I don't know how well this shows up. If you think about it like this, if you're not vaping up any nasty stuff from the tank, you'll definitely be vaping it up from here. But my kind of PSA moment over. Let's discard of the gross bit. Now we can fit the new coil. As I said, this isn't a mesh coil. It's got four individually wrapped coils inside. I do like these coils. But I do prefer the mesh, if I'm honest. Mosquito flying around. Let's just let him go about his day. Okay, so it's important that you don't absolutely drench the inside of this with liquid. Okay, some people will take the liquid and just insert drops into the caps seen here. Don't know why I'm taking it to this side. I don't like doing that. I would much prefer to just let the vape sit for a little bit longer to let it soak. I suppose that comes down to personal preference. So now we just take the coil and we slot it into the base. Hey, little microphone. How are you doing? Sneaking into shot like that. So now the coil is securely fitted, fastened, screwed in to the base. We can take the tank, place it back on top, and just screw these ends back together. have a partially built tank. Next up is the housing, or the roof, I suppose you could also call it. This is a section that allows for refilling. And secure, nice and snug. The mouthpiece. This goes on with a click and a slight twist just to really get it secured down. If it doesn't go on the first time, don't panic. Just simply try again until this one is being particularly nuisancey today. So let's just keep trying, shall we? There we go. Now we have a fully built tank with a brand new coil. Please screw the tank back onto the body, being sure not to over tighten it. You don't want to ruin the thread. New vape ready to go. All we have to do is add the liquid. And to do that, we simply remove the top once again, just to reveal the holes for the liquid. Now the reason I put this on and then the mouthpiece is simply to give me something a little sturdier to lean on. So because this has nicotine shots, I'm going to make sure it's screwed on. Of course, with them being interesting flavours and smells, children will probably want to drink it. It's poisonous, so kind of don't let them drink it. Toxic, whatever. Either way, it's not a good day if you drink it. So carefully insert. Doesn't matter which side. You want to fill it as much as you can to the top. The coil will absorb some of the liquid anyway, so it's natural to see the level drop a little bit. So we'll put this to one side. Put the top on first. One finished vape. All we have to do now is add the batteries. Does tell you which way the battery needs to face, because this one is waterproof, as I said, or water resistant at least. It takes a little bit of pressure to really make sure the mechanism and the latch stays closed. Since it's closed, 5 clicks will do it. See, it's powered on. We have a coil rating, volts. We have our buff counter back. The amp is at 0.0. With a quick press, we can see the figures bounce around. I don't know how well that shows up on camera. Very, very quick press is all it takes. Some vapes you can set up incorrectly with a new coil, meaning you've either over tightened it or you've got liquid underneath this section which is stopping any current from getting to the coil itself, and that prevents it from actually working. So a super quick press will tell you. Never, in any circumstance, sit, press and hold the button unless you are vaping. You will burn your coil and damage your vape. And that's just pointless, really. So this was my little setup video. Change a vape coil. I hope you found it maybe informative, maybe relaxing, just enjoyable. I know it's a little bit different. The audio has been a little bit different as well, with it not being particularly ear based with the sounds, but as I said, these microphones were mainly put here just to pick up any little noises. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. I'll do a video on vaping again in the near future. I'll sit and vape and you'll get to listen to the breathing in, the crackle of the vape, the breathing out. And I'll talk about some of the different vapes I own, because this is my third big mod vape. So let me know what you all thought about this video. Loved it, hate it, I love to know. Didn't like my talking style,